The reward that the women will receive to sitting in their houses, Allahu Akbar, it cannot be comprehended. Listen to this hadith of Rasulullah, Abdul Malik ibn Habib relates. Well, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting with the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een. A woman from the Ansar came and she was called Asma. She greeted Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with salam, Ki assalamu alayka ya Rasulullah. And then she said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Inna Allaha arsalaka ila al-nasi kaffa. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent you to the whole of mankind. To the jinn, to the human beings, to the males, to the females, you name it, he sent you to the whole of mankind. فَآمَنَّ بِكَ We believed in you. We followed you. We took you as our prophet. وَصَدَّقْنَا بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ And that what was revealed on you, the Quran, we took it to be true. We accepted it with our heart. ثُمَّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ فَضَّلَكُمْ عَلَى النِّسَاءِ بِفَضَائِلِ شَتَّى Then Allah has given you men superiority over the women in different ways. فَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْجُمُعَ For you is the Jummah prayer. وَالْجَمَعَ For you is the congregational prayer. وَعِيَادَةَ الْمَرْضَى For you is visiting the sick. For you, وَإِتِبَاءَ الْجَنَائِزِ is following the janazah. وَالْحَجْ وَالْعُمْرَةَ For you is the Hajj. For you is the Umrah. وَخَصَّكُمْ بِأَفْضَلْ مِنْ هَذَا And even better than this, الرباط والجهاد في سبيل الله For you is the ribat and for you is the jihad في سبيل الله O Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam What is there for the women? We are the ones that remain in your houses looking after your wealth and property in your absence We are the ones who look after your children who take them to the madrasa bring them back from the madrasa take them to the schools meet with their teachers We are the ones who feed them. We are the ones who change their nappies. We are the ones who clothe them. We are the ones who prepare your meals. We are the ones who sew your clothes. We are the ones who patch them up. We are the ones who do the ironing. We are the places of your desire. It is through us you fulfill your desires. We are the ones that do not let anybody sit on your bed other than yourself. O Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what will we women receive? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turned to the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu ajma'in and said, هل سمعتم منطق مثل هذه المرأة? Have you ever heard a woman speak so eloquently and so much concern about the next world, about the akhirah, about her deen and her sawab? Have you ever seen a woman like this? The Sahaba replied in one voice, وَالَّذِي بَعَثَ بِالْحَقِّ We swear by the one who has sent you with the truth, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have never seen a woman like this ever before. With so much concern about her deen and so much worry about her sawab, we have never seen a woman like this. We couldn't even believe that a woman could actually speak in a manner like this and show so much concern like this. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turned around to this woman and said, وَاسْمَا أَيَّتُهَا الْمَرَأَ انْصَرِفِي وَاعْلَمِي نِسَاءَ حَيِّكِ وَمَنْ لَقِيتِ مِنْ نِسَاءِ الْمُحَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنْصَارِ وَجَمِيعِ نِسَاءِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَاسْمَا go. And tell the women that you meet from your tribe. Tell the women that you meet from the Ansar and the Muhajireen. And tell the women that you meet from the Muslim. Tell any Muslim woman that you meet. That if a woman serves her husband. And is obedient to her husband. And serves him well. Even if it's for a short period of time. Even if it's for 10 minutes. And her husband is pleased with her. For this little thing, يَعْدِلُ الْجِهَادِ وَالْحَجِ وَالْعُمْرَةِ وَإِتِبَاءَ الْجَنَائِزِ وَالْجُمْعَةِ For this little thing, she will receive the reward of the jihad. She will receive the reward of the ribad. She will receive the reward of the jum'ah. She will receive the reward of visiting the sick. Following the janazah, she will receive the reward of the hajj. And she will receive the reward of the umrah for this little thing that she does. She returned home shouting, Allahu Akbar! Because of what she heard from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the reward that a woman will receive. Look what the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam understood from this hadith. She is ill. As Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha is ill. She wakes up in spite of this. She performs wudu, ablution, and then she offers her salah. And after this, she begins to grind flour with the handmill. Her husband Ali says, the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, rest. Take a rest, your illness will deteriorate. And she replies, And this reply is worth more than £1 billion. She says, "Oh my beloved husband, these two things are not such because of which my illness will deteriorate. These two things, to serve Allah and to serve my husband, is the best cure for any sickness. And if one of them becomes the cause of my death, what better death can there be?" This was the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And our sisters believe that the kuffar have liberated them. Every billboard you will see our sisters. And how cheap and how low they have taken women to be. We kid ourselves that they have liberated us. In reality, from these billboards you will see how cheap a woman is. And the mentality of our sisters has become ajeeb. I mean, we will be happy to work in offices and serve the kuffar, serve our bosses, serve all those that come there. We will be happy to work as air hostesses and serve the passengers, run around on the plane, bring drink for him, bring food for him. We will be happy to work in factories. We will be happy to work everywhere. But when it comes to serve the very husband, the Muslim husband, who spends everything to his ability to serve her and her children and provide for them, then we begin to ask for equality. The same thing we will do for the kuffar. We will do for our bosses. We will do exactly the same thing. We will cook for them. We will clean the office. We will move papers from here to there. But when it comes to doing the same thing for the person who was burdened with the responsibility of providing, there we will ask for equality. There we will consider sweeping up the house a bad thing, but we will consider sweeping up the factory a good thing. We will consider sweeping up the shop floor to be a good thing, but sweeping up your very house, the very place where you live in, to provide for your own children, to cook for them, there we will say that the husband has oppressed us. Ajeeb mentality. Yet the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the best of creation, would do all the work in her house herself. To the extent she had grinded so much flour that it left blisters on her hand. And she came because Sayyidina Ali told her to go to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and ask him for a servant to serve us. She comes to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, blisters, seeing the blisters on his daughter's hand. In spite of this, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam sends her back, "Oh Fatima, how can I give you? When the people of the bench, the Ashab al-Suffa, are suffering from starvation, such is their condition that their stomachs have shrunk due to hunger. Oh Fatima, they are more worthy of you than this. I will spend whatever I have on those people and you return to your family." Ittaqillah, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fulfill the rights of your Lord, fulfill the rights of your husband, and do all the chores, do all the homes in your house by yourself. And she replied, "Oh Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I open-heartedly accept your suggestion and I will keep on doing what I used to do in my house. I will keep on doing all the chores in the home, the cooking, the sweeping, the cleaning, everything myself." This was the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A second mistake that our sisters make is demanding too much. You can provide everything, but in spite of this they will think that we don't have this, we don't have that. This is not a good attribute. A Muslim wife should be happy with whatever her husband provides, as long as what he provides is halal and has come from halal sources. Our mothers once asked for an increase in naqla, in expenditure. It was at the time of after the Battle of Ahzab, when Quraiza and Nadir had been defeated. A lot of booty had come, and our mother sat around Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam thinking, "Ya Rasulullah, banatu kisra wa qaisr fil uliy wal ulal wal ima wa nahnu ala ma tarahu min al faqa wal dhiq." That the daughters of the kings Kisra and Qaisr are living lives of luxury. They have jewels, they have fancy clothes, they have everything, they have maids to serve them, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we are living, as you see, in poverty and in hardships and in difficulty. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was so hurt by this. And one or two other incidents that have taken place, that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took an oath that he will not go near one of his wives for a complete month. Relating this incident, Imam Muslim on the authority of Sayyidina Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu says that Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu came to visit Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And all the people were sitting at the doorstep and nobody was given permission to enter. After a while, Abu Bakr and Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu were given permission to enter. When Sayyidina Umar entered, he saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sitting very quiet. And the Azwaj Mutahharat, the Ummahat al-Mu'mineen, were sitting around him. Umar could not tolerate the condition and the sadness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he said to Abu Bakr, "Abu Bakr, I will try my utmost best to make Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam."